Hi, my name is Juan Vicent, and I am the communications manager at Hyperloop UPV.
Hello, my name is Manuel Martinez. I'm one of two technical directors for the Hyperloop UPV team.
It's already been 1 year and we cannot believe it. We still cannot believe it. We wanted only to participate in a competition with more teams, but then the moment when we heard our names, it was amazing. And if this was great, the second prize, the top design concept, was incredible. We were crying like teenagers, and we were only five, but we were screaming like a 50 people team. Our prototype aims to be more than only a prototype for a SpaceX competition, as the specifications used to change every now and then. So we thought that we need another approach. From the very beginning, we envisioned the concept to be as similar as possible to the initial idea from Elon Musk and not to the competition rules. So that way we could have more freedom, and that's what we think they liked about us, that we had more freedom and we stuck to the principle of Elon Musk and not to the rules of the competition.
We made our design thinking that the infrastructure had to be as simple as possible. So our pod has a very interesting levitation system. Now, other teams are using maglev systems, and these systems require rails. By removing the rail, we are virtually reducing the cost of the tube itself by more than an order of magnitude. The propulsion system can be likened to that of an airplane, except there's one big key difference. Our design is 100% renewable and zero emissions. But removing the rail not only helps drive down the cost of the project, but it also helps with passenger comfort, the inertial forces caused when we turn either in a car or in a train. Well, with rails, it is very difficult to mitigate these effects. When moving at very high speeds, the Hyperloop concept, in order to turn, it would have to turn very, very slowly in order to not make the passenger sick or feel high G forces.
It has been amazing since we heard that we had the prize. The press and the media coverage was huge, and it's been really encouraging. We wanted only to make a theoretical proposal, but now we have enlarged the team from 5 to 30 people, and we expect to bring a full prototype for California in summer 2017. We know that the companies can have a huge visibility from this project, so we started making a partnership agreements with several companies, such as the University of Valencia. Polytechnical University of Valencia has supported us from the very beginning, and we are really, really, really proud of being part of this university that supports entrepreneurs.
We're continuing to work on the design revisions, preliminary designs for the systems and subsystems. We are really looking forward to participating in the next phase of the competition, which, like I said before, is in January. We are excited to go show everyone there, students and companies alike, that our system works with our levitation prototype. And we want to discuss the future of transportation with brilliant minds from around the world.
Elon Musk just showed up for the last part of the competition when the jury told us that we won the competition, but he signed our prizes, so we were really proud of having a signature of Elon Musk, and we hope to speak to him if we have a full prototype so we can make this a reality.